Hello everybody, so in my today's video I will be talking about type 1 and type 2 errors. So myself Dr. Sneha Bhatia, MPT in Orthopedics and Sports Rehabilitation, in charge principal at Lead Srimati S.G. Patel Institute of Physiotherapy, Dharmash. So before I start with my short video, I would like to request my audience to please subscribe my channel, as 65% of my audience have yet not subscribed to my channel, so please subscribe the channel, press the bell icon to get notified for the next video, and share this channel with your friends. So in the context of testing of hypothesis, we can make basically two types of error, so that can be classified as type 1 error and type 2 error. These are the basically two types of error that one can make. So what is type 1 error? So when we are talking about research methodology, we are talking about type 1 error and type 2 error. So what is the meaning of type 1 error? So a type 1 error is also known as an error of the first kind, occurs when the null hypothesis, that is H0, is true but is rejected. A type 1 error may be compared with a so-called false positive. Okay, so that means, suppose we are considering of a test. So test, if it is coming false positive, that means the condition, the disease may not be present, but the test, the laboratory test shows that it is positive, then it will be considered as false positive. So that is the same case of type 1 error. Okay, so type 1 error can be compared with the false positive test. So type 1 error occurs when we believe in falsehood. The rate of the type 1 error is called the size of the test and denoted by the Greek letter alpha. So type 1 error is denoted by the Greek letter alpha. And what is the meaning of false positive? False positive means, suppose a patient is there, patient is having signs and symptoms of cough, then he is having sore throat and he is tested for COVID-19. Okay, now it is possible that the patient may have only normal flu and not the COVID-19, but still, if the laboratory report shows that he is positive for the COVID-19, then it will be considered as a false positive, because our patient is only having normal symptoms of flu. He is not having COVID-19 in reality, but when the laboratory test is showing that it is positive, that will be considered as a false positive test. So that is the same with the type 1 error. So type 1 error is denoted by the Greek letter alpha. It usually equals the significance level of a test. So alpha is also known as the significance level of a test. If type 1 error is fixed at 5%, it means that there are about 5 chances in 100 that we will reject the null hypothesis when null hypothesis is true. So when we are planning of any research study or any randomized control trial, we have to determine our sample size. Okay, like how many sample size means how many patients we will be recruiting for our project. Let's say, suppose if we are having two groups, group A and group B. So if we have to take 25 patients in each group, then how we will determine that? We will have the sample size calculation by the formula. So in that formula, we have to put the level of significance, that is alpha. So always we keep it at 5%. So 5%, when we keep the level of significance or the alpha at 5%, that means we can be 95% sure that we will not commit type 1 error. So that's what they are saying, that in 100, when we set the alpha at 5%, that means only 5 chances out of 100 that we will reject the null hypothesis when null hypothesis is true. What is null hypothesis? Null hypothesis states that there is no difference between any group. Okay, suppose we are having two groups, two, group A and group B, and we are giving some exercise for group A and we are just giving placebo treatment for group B. So what should be null hypothesis for this kind of study? Null hypothesis states that there is no significant difference between the groups. So that is the null hypothesis. Okay, so that's why we are fixing the alpha, that is the level of significance, at 5%. So in our study, there will be only 5% chance that we will reject the null hypothesis when null hypothesis will be true. So what is the meaning of type 1 error? वी आर रिजेक्टिंग द नल हाइपोथीसिस व्हेन इट इज ट्रू. सो नल हाइपोथीसिस मीन्स देर इज नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू ग्रुप. सो नेक्स्ट, वॉट इज टाइप टू एरर? टाइप टू एरर इज ऑल्सो नोन एज एन एरर ऑफ द सेकेंड काइंड. अकर्स वेन द नल हाइपोथीसिस इज फॉल्स बट इट फेल्स टू बी रिजेक्टेड. सो टाइप टू एरर मीन्स एक्सेप्टिंग द हाइपोथीसिस विच शुड हैव बीन रिजेक्टेड. सो वेन वी आर कमिटिंग द टाइप टू एरर, वेन वी आर एक्सेप्टिंग द हाइपोथीसिस वेन इट शुड हैव बीन रिजेक्टेड, देन इट इज कंसिडर्ड एज टाइप टू एरर. सो what is the meaning of accepting the hypothesis when it should have been rejected? See, when you are saying the alternative hypothesis, null hypothesis means there is no difference between the two group, okay, whether you are giving placebo treatment or you are giving exercise, there is no difference between the group. But what is the alternate hypothesis? Alternate hypothesis thinks or it states that one group is better than the other. For example, I told you we are having two group, group A and group B. Group A we are giving the exercise and group B we are just giving the placebo treatment, okay. So that will become the, what will be the alternate hypothesis for this kind of study? Alternate hypothesis will be that group A is having better results than group B. That will be the alternate hypothesis. It is also called as hypothesis of significant difference. Okay, significant difference. When the difference exists between the two group, it will be called as alternate hypothesis. So a type 2 error may be compared with also so called false negative. Okay, what is the false negative test means? Suppose we are having a patient who is having signs and symptoms of COVID-19 and we send his test, okay, for laboratory test. If he is really having COVID-19 and still the laboratory test confirms that he is not having the disease and it is negative test, even when the patient is actually having the disease, the laboratory test says that it is not present, it is negative, then in that case it will be considered as a false negative. So type 2 error can be compared to false negative. So type 2 error is committed when we fail to believe a truth. Okay, so what case we are failing to believe? Alternative hypothesis. Okay, so type 2 error occurs when one rejects the alternative hypothesis, fails to reject the null hypothesis. Okay, so in type 2 error, when we are committing in, when we fail to reject the null hypothesis. Okay, when one rejects the alternative hypothesis. So when the alternative hypothesis is true and we fail and we reject it, that time we will commit type 2 error. Okay, so again remember, a type 2 error occurs when one rejects the alternative hypothesis when the alternative hypothesis is true. Okay, now the rate of the type 2 error is denoted by the Greek letter beta and related to the power of the test. So type 2 error is also called as the power of the test, which is equal to 1 minus beta. So in the tabular form, two errors can be presented as, so null hypothesis is true, okay, but we are rejecting the null hypothesis, that will be considered as type 1 error. It is also called as false positive. Okay, null hypothesis is false and we reject it, that means it is true positive. Null hypothesis is true but we fail to reject the null hypothesis, that is the correct outcome, that will be true negative. If null hypothesis is false and we fail to reject the null hypothesis, then it will be considered as type 2 error, that is the false negative. Okay, so that is the thing. Here also the same thing has been shown in the picture, hypothesis testing outcome. Okay, when it is accurate, when it is considered as type 1 error, when it is considered as type 2 error. Okay, next. So what are the differences between the type 1 error and the type 2 error? So type 1 error is when the statistic calls for rejection of a null hypothesis which is factually true. And type 2 error means is when a statistic does not give enough evidence to reject a null hypothesis even when the null hypothesis should factually be rejected. So we may reject null hypothesis when null hypothesis is true, is known as the type 1 error, remember. And we may accept the null hypothesis when in fact null hypothesis is not true but alternative hypothesis is true, so that will be considered as type 2 error. Okay, So remember, type 1 error, you are rejecting the null hypothesis. Okay, H0 is a null hypothesis which you are rejecting when actually it is true. That is the type 1 error. And type 2 error means you are accepting the null hypothesis when it is actually true. You should actually accept the alternative hypothesis. So that is the type 2 error. A type 1 error is also called as false positive. Type 2 error is also called as false negative. So type 1 error is denoted by Greek letter alpha. Type 2 error is denoted by Greek letter beta. So null hypothesis, okay, it is associated with type 1 error. So here alternative hypothesis, okay, when you are failing to accept it, then it is considered as type 2 error. So how can we reduce the type 1 error? So prescriptive testing is used to increase the level of confidence, which in turn reduces the type 1 error. The chances of making a type 1 error are reduced by increasing the level of confidence. So we have to increase the level of confidence. Next is reducing the type 2 error. So descriptive testing is used to better describe the test condition and acceptance criteria, which in turn reduces the type 2 errors. This increases the number of times we reject the null hypothesis. So with a resulting increase in the number of type 1 errors, okay, so rejecting null hypothesis when it was really true should not have been rejected. Okay, but what is happening when we are reducing one type of error, then the chances of increasing other error is there. So reducing one type of error comes at the expense of increasing the other type of the error. The same means cannot reduce both types of errors simultaneously. So that is all about type 1 error and type 2 error. So this type 1 error and type 2 error, type 1 error and type 2 error are most commonly asked question for short note, okay, as well as long question. It can be asked for research methodology paper. So thank you for watching this video. If you have enjoyed watching this video, then please subscribe to my channel, press the bell icon to get notified for the next video, and share this channel with your friends. Thank you.